comes Oberon.
Oh,
girdle round about the earth in 40 minutes. Remote 7 leagues, and she respects me as her only son. Fair gentle Hermia, may I marry thee, and to that place the sharp Athenian law compelling thee to marry with Demetrius cannot pursue us. If thou lovest me, then there will I go with thee, there will I go.
I swear to thee, and I swear to thee, man. comes here. I am invisible, I will overhear their conference.
I love thee not, therefore pursue me not. Where is Lysander and Iphemia? The one has slain the other, spareth me. Thou toldst me they were stolen unto this wood, and here am I, and woe within this wood, because I cannot meet my Hermia. Hence, get thee gone, and follow me no more.
Thank you. Is all our company here?
Ah!
If we're merciful and generally, man by man, according to the script.
First, good Peter Quince, say what the play treats of.
Mary, the play is the most lamentable comedy, and most cruel death of Pyramus and Thisbe.
Of Pyramus and Thisbe.
A very good piece of work, I assure you, and a merry. Now, good Peter Quince, call forth your actors by the scroll. Masters, spread yourselves. Answer as I call you. Nick Bottom, the weaver. Ready, name what part I am for, and proceed. You, Nick Bottom, are set down for Pyramus. What is Pyramus? A lover or a tyrant? A lover that kills himself most gallant for love. My chief humor is for a tyrant. I could play earthly Sorelli, or about to bear a catty. Don't make us live the raging arch and cheering shots to break loose the prison gate. And Phoebus got shall shine to bar, shall shine to bar, and make a mark. And Phoebus Goss shall shine to God and make not the foolish fates. This war's locked in. Now name the rest of the players. Francis Flute. This is Erky's vein, Erky's vein, a tyrant's vein, a tyrant's vein. Francis Flute.
My mother is more condoling.
Bellows Mender.
Here, Peter Quince.
Flute, you must take Thisbe on you.
What is Thisbe? Thisbe, a wandering knight.
It is the lady that Pyramus must love.
Nay, faith, nay, faith, let not me be a woman. Let not me be a woman.
I have a beard coming.
That's all one. We shall play it in a mask, and you may speak as small as you will, and I may hide my face. Let me play this be cool. I speak in a monstrous little voice. No, no! You must play Pyramus and Flute, you Thisbe. Well, proceed.
Ah, Pyramus, my love, my Thisbe, dear. Here, Peter Quince, Pyramus, my love, dear, my Thisbe, dear.
Tom Snout, the tinker.
Here, Peter Quince,
Pyramus,
my love, dear, my Thisbe.
Snug the joiner.
Why be
no. But, and I hope, here is a play fit bed of you. The lion's heart written. Where you, if be, give it me. Extempore, for it is nothing but roaring. Let me play the lion tool. I will roar, that I will do any man's heart good to hear me. I will roar, that I will make the duke say. Let him roar again. Let him roar again.
And you should do it too, terribly. You would fright the duchess and the ladies, that they would shriek. They would shriek, and that were enough to hang us all.
That would hang, that would hang,
hang, hang, hang, hang, hang, hang us, hang us, hang us, hang us, hang us,
every
mother's
soul. But I will aggravate my
boy, so that I will bore you as gently as any sucking dove. I will row you and twirl any nightingale.
You can play no part but Pyramus, for Pyramus is a sweet-faced man, a proper man, a most lovely gentleman-like man. Therefore you must needs play Pyramus. Well, I will undertake it. You, request you, and desire you to con them by tonight. Here we will rehearse anon. We will meet. And here we may rehearse most obscenely and courageously. Take pains, be perfect.
Adieu.
At the Duke's so we meet.
Adieu.
Sweet friend, thy love near altar.
none, on whose eyes I might approve. This hour's force in stirring love, night and silence, night and silence. Of Athens he doth well. This is he, my master said, despiseth the Athenian maid. Churl, upon thine eyes I throw all the power this charm doth hold. So awake when I am gone, for I must now to Oberon.
Your love and might to honor. Thank you.
merry band. Helena is here at hand, and the youth mistook by me. Shall we their fond pageant see? Lord, what fools these mortals be.
I shall do think that I should ruin scorn.
These vows are Hermia's, will you give her one?
I had no judgment when to her I swore.
Nor none in my mind, now you give her one.
Demetrius loves shall I compare thine eye, Christmas muddy? Oh, how ripe in show thy lips, this kissing Jenny's tempting grow. And pure congealed white, toy tore snow, fanned with the eastern wind, turns to a crow. When thou holdst up thy hand, oh, let me kiss this princess of pure white, the seal of bliss.
Oh, hell, a spite!
Goddess,
oh, hell, if a spite!
Perfect,
oh,
divine!
Hell, I'll say you all have been to set against me.
You are unkind,
oh, merry men.
Demetrius, be not so, not so, for you love her.
When thy love comes,
you know I
the
know
that is thy.
I'll not trust your word.
What
should
I hurt her, strike her, kill her dead. All although I hate her, hate her, on the common sword.
What can you do me, my
sword? And the king I heard you, I will know. I and I love you so that your heart is wrong.
You counterfeit! You puppet! You puppet!
Why so? I bat twiggles the game. Now I perceive that she has made compare between our statures. She hath urged her height. She hath urged her height. And with her personage, her tall personage, her height forsooth, she hath prevailed with him. And are you grown so high in his esteem? I am so dwarfish and so low. How low am I? Though painted deep, oh, speak. How low am I? I am not yet so low, but that my nails can reach unto thine eyes.
Shadows. I mistook. I mistook.
Thou seest these lovers seek a place to fight. I therefore, Robin, overcast the night and leave this rival so astray, as one come not with
yet ere day.
Up and down, I will lead them up and down. I am feared in field and town, goblin lead them up and down. To plainer ground.
Thank you.
As thou wast wont to be, see as thou wast wont to see, Dian's bud or Cupid's flower has such force and blessed power. Be as thou wast wont to be.
send a mark. I do hear the morning lark.
Are you sure that we are awake? It seems to me that we yet sleep. We dream. These things
like you comes, call me, and I will answer. My next is most fabulous, fabulous. No man can tell what. Methought I was, and methought I had. But man is but an ass if he can offer to say what methought I had. The eye of man hath not heard. Man hath not seen. Man's hand is not able to taste, his tongue to conceive, nor his heart to report. What my dream was. I will get Peter Quince, the carpenter, to write a ballad of this dream, and it shall be called.
Bottom's dream, bottom's dream, because it hath no bottom. I will sing it in the latter end of the play, before the Duke, peradventure to make it the more gracious, I shall sing it at her death.
Have you sent to Bottom's house? Is he come home yet?
He cannot be heard of. Out of doubt he is transported. If he cometh, then the play is marred. It goes not forward, doth it? It is not possible. You have not a man in all Athens able to discharge Pyramus. But no.
He is simply the best wit of any handicraft
in Athens. Yea, and the best person too.
Masters, the Duke is coming from the temple. If a spot had gone forward, we had all been made men.
Oh, sweet Polly Bottom, thus hath he lost sixpence a day during his life. And the Duke had not given him sixpence a day for playing Pyramus. I'll be hanged, he would have deserved it, sixpence a day. Sixpence in Pyramus, or nothing.
He could not escape this.
He could not but escape this.
Where are these lands?
Bottom.
Where are these hearts?
Oh, Lord, was the leisure to stay?
Bottom! I am to discourse wonders, and ask me not what.
Let us hear, sweet Bottom,
not a word of me.
All that I will tell you is that the Duke hath died, and the play is preferred.
The play is preferred.
Stand up.
I know you two were rival enemies. How came this gentle concord in the world?
My lord, I shall reply amazedly. I went with Hermia thither. Our intent was to be gone from Athens, where we might, without the peril of the Athenian law.
My lord, fair Helen told me of their stealth, and I in fury did afford them. Fair Helena, in fancy, following me, but my good lord.
Fair lovers, of this discourse we more will hear anon. Hermia, I will obey your father's will. For in the town I am high with us, these couples shall eternally be knit. Joy,
masks, what dances shall we have to while away this long age of 3 hours between our after supper and bedtime?
A tedious brief scene of young Pyramus and his love, Thisbe, very tragical mirth.
Many and tragical, tedious and brief, that is hot ice and wondrous strange snow.
What are they that do play it?
Hard-handed men that work in Athens here, which never labor till now.
I will hear that plea. For never anything can be amiss when simpleness and duty tender it. Take your places, ladies. With a lime and rough cast,
that present wall, that vile wall, which did these love asunder. This man with lant on dog and bush of thorn presenteth moonshine. This grisly beast is Lionhide by name. For all the rest, let lion, moonshine, wall, and lovers twain at large discourse. While here they do remain.
I wonder if the lion be to speak.
No wonder, fair lady, one lion may, when many asses do.
In this same interlude it doth befall that I once now by name present a wall, and such a wall as I would have you think, that add in it a crannied hole or take. And this the cranny is right and sinister, through which the fearful lovers are to whisper.
Would you desire lion and hare to sing better?
It is the wittiest partition that ever I heard discourse.
Cyrenus draws near the wall. Silence!
O Grimlock Knight, O knight with hue so black, O knight with ever heart when day is not, O knight, alack, alack, alack.
I fear my Thisby's promise is forgot.
And thou, O wall, O sweet, O lovely wall, that stands between our father's ground and mine, thou wall, O wall, O sweet and
stones for thus deceiving me. The wall, methinks, being sensible, should curse again.
No, in truth, sir, he should not.
Deceiving me is Thisby's cue.
Yonder she comes.
Hast thou heard my moans for parting my fair Pyramus and me? My cherry lips have often kissed thy stones, thy stones with the lime and hair lit up in thee.
I see your voice, now will I to the chink. Why, and I can hear my Thisby's face.
My love, thou art,
think.
Think what thou wilt, I am thy love's grace.
My love thou art, my love I think.
Think what thou wilt, for kiss me, kiss me.
My love,
me,
thou, my love, 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 my love.
Wilt thou at least to lead me straightway?
Thy life, thy death, I come without. Thy life, I come without. I come without. Delay, delay.
Thus have I while my part discharged so. Being done, thus wall away doth go. Away, 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 away doth go.
This is the silliest stuff that ever I heard.
The best in this kind are but shadows, and the worst are the worst if imagination amends them. Here come two noble beasts in, a man and a lion. Let us listen to the moon.
This land on doth the horned moon present. He should have worn the horns on his head. I myself, the man in the moon, do seem to be. The man should be put into the lamp on. How's it else the man in the moon? This lantern doth
she dares not come there for the candle.
Proceed, moon.
All I have to tell you is that this lantern is the moon. I, the man in the moon. This thornbush, my thornbush, and this dog, my dog.
I am weary of this moon. Would he would change?
But silence, here comes Thisbe.
This is old Minnie's tomb. Where is
my love?
Where is my
love?
Where is
my love?
Cut thread and come,
well,
crushed,
cold, and well.
Be sure.
from a deer, and she's no know which was the fairest there. But there's one far out sword, and would the clock of these.
Now am I dead, now am I fled, my soul is in the sky. Come lose thy light, moon, take thy flight. Now die, 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 die.
With the help of a surgeon, he might yet recover and prove an ace.
The earth is becomes, and her passion ends the play.
I hope she will be brief.
Asleep, my love, what dead, my dove? O Pyramus, arise! Speak, speak, quite dumb. Speak, speak, quite dumb. Dead, dead, dead.
Thank you. sent with broom before to sweep the dust behind the door. Shadows have offended. Think but this, and all is mended. That you have but slumbered here, while these visions did appear. Gentles, do not reprehend. If you pardon, we will mend, else the puck a liar call. So good night unto you all. Give me your hands if we be friends, and Robin shall restore amends.